Welcome to Recap King. In this video, we will explain a movie released in 2019 titled Super 30. This movie is based on the life of Putna-based mathematician Anand Kumar, who runs the famed Super 30 program for IIT aspirants in Putna. When everyone thinks his dream is too high, he tries to prove that his 30 students can score success. How is the story of his life journey? Let's find out in Super 30. Super 30 begins with the story of the past, where there is a young man, a mathematician who lives in the city of Patna, India, named Anand Kumar. At that time, Anand was seen at an event to receive a medal for his achievements. The event was attended by the Indian Minister of Education, Ram Singh, who gave a speech. In his speech, he promised to open the door of his house for 24 hours for anyone who needed help in the form of emotional support, social assistance, material and others. After winning the medal, he goes to his girlfriend, Sapriya, a rich girl, and shows off the medal he just won. After graduating from high school, Anand often spent time going to the library at Benares Hindu University to read the latest free math journal books and try to solve math problems published by these foreign journals. Unfortunately, the librarian caught his actions. He was expelled by the librarian because he was not one of the students from the campus. Anand then protested that education is a right for everyone. However, because the librarian only followed the rules, he had to expel him from the place. Anand relented and left the library. As he was about to leave the library, he was approached by one of the library staff. The library staff suggested that he could come and read all the journals published abroad for free in the library as long as he wrote articles there. Arriving at home, he then tried to write a journal by solving a problem from the foreign mathematical journal. At home, he continued to take notes and work on mathematical formulas until the walls in his house were filled with numbers and mathematical formulas. After that, he wrote all the mathematical answers in a paper containing number theory. This paper was published in the Mathematical Spectrum and the Mathematical Gazette and sent to Cambridge University in England. A few weeks later, Anand received a letter from Cambridge University inviting him to come there. The news made Anand and his family very happy. Later, Anand and his father came to visit the home of the Minister of Education, Ram Singh, to collect his promise the other day when he gave a speech in their city. However, the response given by Ram Singh was beyond their expectations. Ram pretended to have forgotten his promise by dodging not being able to help Anand. Disappointed with the response from the Minister of Education, finally Anand and his father returned to their city empty-handed. Sometime later, Anand's father tried to find loans here and there so that his son could go to England for college. However, all his efforts were in vain as no one was willing to lend him money. Until one night, Anand's father suddenly passed out due to a heart attack. Anand and his older brother immediately took his father to the hospital on a bicycle. Unfortunately, in the middle of the way, the bicycle chain broke so that his father's life could not be saved. Not long after, his father died. After his father died, Anand had to take on his father's duties to support his family. He went from house to house selling food and even used a letter from Cambridge University to wrap food. Until one day, he was hit by a car on the side of the road. It turned out that the owner of the car was named Lalan Singh. He is an entrepreneur engaged in education. When he recognized Anand as a mathematician, he then invited him to come with him to his house. Arriving there, Anand saw a painting of a famous university in India called the Indian Institutes of Technology. When he saw Anand staring at the painting of the IIT building, Lalan then explained that many rich parents in India are willing to spend a lot of money to get additional tutoring so that their children can pass and be accepted at the campus. Then Lalan offered Anand a wad of money as long as he would teach at his own course. Lalan's courses are enrichment courses intended for children of the rich to pass and enter the campus of their dreams. Thanks to his passion and intelligence, Anand became a popular teacher at the course. Hearing of Anand's achievements, many rich parents flocked to register their children to get additional lessons by taking the course, so that the course owned by Lalan has also significantly benefited from the presence of Anand teaching there. Anand's life has changed drastically. Previously, he lived very difficultly and deprived. Now he earns a lot of money from his teaching fee. His style of dress has changed and looks more trendy. He also now has the blessing of Sapriya's father, a wealthy man, to continue his relationship with his daughter. One night, Anand saw a poor boy from a pedicab driver who looked very serious about studying. He then asked the pedicab driver why his son did not continue his education to a higher level. The pedicab driver replied that he could not afford to send his son to college because of the high cost. He then told a Mahabharata story where Guru Arjuna saw another student whose archery ability was greater than Arjuna's. However, Guru Arjuna asked the boy to cut off his finger so that Arjuna would not lose his position as the best archer. This also happens in the real world, where the king's son will remain king. From the pedicab driver's story, Anand remembered his own story when his father was desperately looking for money for his trip to Cambridge University. After that, he was touched and intends to open a free class for poor children who want to learn. Eventually, with the help of his younger brother, Anand started selling his stuff to open a free class called Super 30 where he would screen from thousands of registrants and only accept 30 people to study for free at his place. Hearing Anand's decision to open the free school, Lalan's course was threatened with bankruptcy. The problem is, the students don't want to study with any other teacher besides Anand. Anand's decision to stop working and prefer to make schooling free also made Supriya disappointed, so she broke up with him and married another man. News of Anand's free school began to spread across India, so flocks of poor children from various places in India came to Anand's place to study for free. While teaching the 30 poor children who were selected to attend the free school at his place, Lalan suddenly came by offering him to return to teaching at his course. He then gave a speech in front of the 30 poor children and scared them by giving predictions about the possibility that one of them would fail to pass to IIT. Hearing the speech made the 30 poor children become discouraged. However, after Lalan left, Anand then rekindled their spirits to not be discouraged. Anand mentioned that the bachelor's degrees that they will achieve will motivate their students to learn again and they will be excited to pursue their dreams by studying very hard. Elsewhere, Lalan is having a meeting with his staff to discuss his leaving his course. Lalan's educational mafia business is on the verge of collapsing because the wealthy children who study at his course refuse to study there again if he is not the teacher. Realizing that his business will be destroyed because of Anand, Lalan feels revenge and starts waging war drums against him. The first step taken by Lalan was to send a thug to threaten him. The thugs he hired contacted Anand and asked for the thug's ration money. If he refuses, then the goons ask him to close his free school. However, Anand ignored the threat. He still teaches the poor children in his place. Seeing that his first attempt failed, Lalan changed his strategy to attack Anand. He ordered several people to cut off the electricity at Anand's residence. However, Anand's students could create backup electricity at his free school because of the knowledge that Anand had taught them. So Lalan's second attack on Anand failed again. A third attack was launched in which Lalan incited the people around Anand's house. The neighbors then came to Anand's house, so a misunderstanding occurred. However, Anand was able to explain to the neighbors so that Lalan's third attempt failed. The lack of facilities and threats that came did not make Anand afraid and give up. However, a new problem arose. Anand and his 30 students were threatened with starvation because his money supply was running low. He could not provide enough food for the students who studied there. He was forced to return to work for Lalan with a heavy heart. Lalan promised to feed his students for 3 months. However, Anand's students will be pitted against students at Lalan's course. If he loses, then Anand must close his free school. The agreement was also written in a letter of agreement witnessed by a male notary who turned out to be Supriya's husband. The competition day arrived. After the exam was carried out, it was announced that the winners were students from Lalan's course. Based on the agreement, Anand was asked to close his free school. However, a reporter asked to see the agreement letter. The notary then looked for the agreement in his bag. Unfortunately, the agreement letter could not be found. Apparently, Supriya had taken and hidden the agreement letter. It was also Supriya who invited the journalist to ask about the agreement letter when the competency results were announced. Seeing this, Anand did not waste the opportunity. He said that he did not acknowledge the existence of the agreement. After returning from that competency, Anand asked his students why they couldn't do the questions well. Apparently, his students feel inferior when dealing with rich children, so suddenly, their brains go blank and they can't think straight. One day, Anand and his students were eating at a restaurant. There Anand talked to the restaurant owner and gave a prediction that the restaurant would go bankrupt within a year due to losses. This was due to the wrong financial calculations. As a skilled mathematician, he gave details of the wrong financial calculations. Seeing this, the restaurant owner was worried that what Anand described would happen. Then, he asked Anand to provide a solution to help prevent his restaurant from going bankrupt. Anand did not waste this opportunity. He offered an agreement that if the restaurant owner fed 30 of his students for 3 months, he would provide a solution. Finally, the restaurant owner agreed. Finally, Anand's food problem was temporarily resolved. Elsewhere, Lalan was facing the Minister of Education. He was threatened by the Minister of Education for not dealing with Anand, who caused a lot of losses for the education mafia business in India. He is asked to stop Anand at any cost. From the media, Anand received information that his life was in danger. Hearing the threat, Anand's brother reported it to the police station. Unfortunately, before the police took action, Anand was shot by two unknown strangers who attacked him while he was traveling. He was shot in the waist and fell to the ground. Seeing that Anand was still alive, the two foreign men intended to shoot him in the head. Luckily, their gun jammed and failed to shoot. They lifted Anand's body into the middle of the train tracks, but their attempts failed, as Anand's brother suddenly came to his rescue with a shotgun. Hearing that his men failed to kill Anand, Lalan then ordered his other men to kill him in the hospital and his 30 students at his house. It turned out that the conversation was overheard by one of Lalan's assistants who had studied at Anand's place. He immediately ran to tell the information. Arriving at the hospital, Anand's brother asked one of the doctors on duty to help his brother. The doctor asked him to fill out the form first, rather than directly helping Anand, who was already dying from being shot. Finally, a strange man asked another doctor to help treat Anand. Meanwhile, the situation at Anand's house looks tense. Lalan's men had come to storm his house. However, the 30 students had prepared weapons which they made from the items in the house. Learning from the theories and experiments taught by Anand, the students were able to make perfunctory weapons and succeeded in stopping Lalan's men. The story changes during the entrance exam at the IIT campus. Anand's 30 students, along with thousands of other students from across India, took the entrance exam at this favorite campus. Then, the results of the announcement arrived. Anand anxiously waited for the exam results. When his younger brother came and informed him that his 30 students had successfully passed the entrance exam and were accepted to continue their education at the campus, Anand burst into tears of joy. The film ends.